Good morning! I haven't made a video in ages, so I figured that I would do a video on how I make my coffee every day because I have two new toys that make the process extra fun. I'm going to start with this electric tea kettle that I actually bought through my Open Sky store myself because I really wanted one and I do get a little bit of a discount, so that helps. And I usually heat my water for coffee in the microwave, but since getting this, it's super easy because it heats up water really fast. And probably the number one thing that I'm going to use this for is when I take bubble baths. We keep our hot water heater low enough that the water, like, just when you get to, you know, where your body will be full, it starts getting cold. So pouring hot water in will make such a big difference. I used to heat a big pot of water on the stove. This is going to be so much quicker. So I'm going to go ahead and turn this on, and I filled it just about to the minimum, about 2.5 cups, which is more than I need, but it should be ready by the time I finish talking about my new French press. This is my Bodum Brazil model French press that I got with some money I got for my birthday. And they're pretty cheap. It was like, I think, $20 to $25. My old French press was about this big, and it only made about 1.5 cups. So it was perfect for me by myself, but whenever Matt was here on the weekends, we either had to fight over who had to get 1/2 cup, or we would have to clean the whole French press before we made a 2nd cup. So I absolutely love this. It is so, like, user-friendly, and of course it's my favorite color green. So our water is now, as you can see, it's heating up in there. Here is some of my Fresh Market Christmas blend coffee, and I hope that you can still hear me. I mix it with probably like 60 to 70% decaf, which is pumpkin spice in this canister, and then it's probably only 30% caffeine because I have major trouble when it comes to caffeine. So I open the French press and put 3 heaping tablespoons, or actually, I don't know if it's a tablespoon, it's a coffee scooper thing that came with the French press. So I do 3 of those, and my caf and decaf are already mixed, so I don't have to do that every morning. And then I also fill one of my mugs with about 2 tablespoons or so of organic milk, about that much. And I heat this in the microwave for 30 seconds because I just like the idea of adding warm to warm. I think there's like something with food science about adding acid to fat or whatever, but you're always supposed to add the coffee to the milk, and it emulsifies better maybe, and when it's warm, I think that it gets a little bit more froth, so that's always a good thing. So I'm going to put this back in the fridge. And this whole process used to take me about 8 minutes, and I don't think the electric tea kettle has really saved any time, but it's definitely more convenient. So it just clicked off. That means it is just at a boiling, and I'm actually going to wait like another minute or so just to let this like lose the little bit of heat there, and my milk is ready. And normally I would be making oatmeal while, you know, so I'm not like just sitting here with this, I'm making oatmeal on the stovetop. So I'll take this opportunity to organize, and you'll also notice that in our upper cabinets we keep our everyday pots and pans, stuff that we use all the time, rather than down here, because who likes to bend over? That's a little tidbit I have. And I also like keeping my coffee in a closet, and thanks to those of you who told me not to keep it in the freezer, because every time I open this closet to get a pot or pan out, my delicious flavored coffees make a wonderful smell. Okay, so I don't know why, you're not supposed to add boiling water to your French press, but now that it has stopped bubbling, it is safe to add. And so I'm just gonna pour this on. That's probably good. I still haven't gotten used to the new system quite yet. And I'm gonna set my timer for 4 minutes. Again, now I would be like finishing the oatmeal and putting it in a bowl and getting the toppings going while this is going. And then I get one of my iced tea spoons. Milk is beeping at me. And I usually wait like 30 seconds to a minute, and then I give this a big stir. And you can see how there is some nice froth forming. See this line? I think that that is called the bloom, but I'm not positive. So I will come back to you in about 3 minutes when we're ready to pour. And the timer's going off. So we will come over here and position this nice press lid on. I'm trying to make this video camera work here, okay? And we slowly, as to emulsify the oils, press. And then there's our nice heated milk. You pour. And I think that French press coffee has more body than regular coffee, but I mean, it's not really enough difference that you could really like tell. I mean, I think that you can tell, but that's not to say that regular coffee doesn't have excellent body at times too. I think it's more about the coffee than the method, or the coffee bean that you use than the method, but I don't think I'll ever go back to French press. I just think that there's something kind of romantic about it, and I like the taste, and I love my new toys. So, if you'd like to purchase these, go to the Open Sky store, or seek them out at your local cooking shops. Have a wonderful day!